How do you almost kiss? Okay, you either do or you don't. We didn't, and we wouldn't have. You got it?
Cooper, think back.
I don't need to think back.
No, yes, I came over your house after the trial, right? Now, maybe you were feeling vulnerable, or maybe you were feeling sympathetic, or maybe it was just a whole lot of different things at the same time. For a very long time, it was building up.
Too much time on your hands, because I remember that night, too, Ituro. Yes, you showed up at my place because you had been exposed as a big fat liar on the stand by Ross. Ross had proven to everybody that you were just trying to get back at Danny to avenge your father's murder. And I gave you, okay, yeah, I gave you a little sympathy. I gave you a little understanding.
You'd give me a whole lot more than that if I'd stuck around. Listen, we both know that, okay? Something happened that night, Cooper. Something happened, and you can't pretend that it didn't. You just can't. He wanted justice. That's what he worked for all of his life, justice. And that's all I really want. You know? Justice. And to this day, no justice. So just admit it. Don't be shy. It's not the right time.
You are an arrogant, self-absorbed jerk. I mean, come on. You seriously think that there's something going on here between us? You're more delusional than I thought. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Out the door. You know what? Okay, maybe I'm too weak to toss you out. But Maida's right upstairs. I don't think you want to press your luck with her.
I'm not buying it.
What?
I'm not buying this whole little act of yours. I'm not buying it. I can see through you, okay? I can see beneath the bulletproof facade that you go tramping around in. I know you. I've seen you with your kids. I saw you on the couch that night with me. So you can pretend all you want, but I know that you remember that we almost kissed.
Good. You know what? Wait. You need to get a hobby. You got too much time on your hands.
I know that you remember it, Harley. Okay? I know that you're picturing it in your mind. Right now. You sat down on the couch next to me. And you were touched by my story. You were touched by me. You leaned in close. And it would have been so easy to have just given in. How many times have you replayed this over and over in your mind in the last several months? How many times have you wondered what it would be like if you just had leaned in and closed your eyes? That kind of hurt, Coop.
How dare you? How dare you? How dare you come here and try to force yourself on me? How dare you do that? Who do you think you are? You know, I just had a baby, okay? I just had a baby, and I'm exhausted, and you come here and you try to take advantage of that? I mean, what is that? You know, I don't want you. Ituro, I never have. I don't sit there and think about you the way that you think I do, and I certainly don't dream about
calm
you.
Down.
Okay, no, I don't want to calm down. I don't want to calm down, okay? because I wanted you to go, and you wouldn't leave. Look, I'm obviously, you know what I've been through. I'm confused. I'm confused, and I'm weak, and I can barely stand here. And you know, I don't want that. I don't want that. I don't want you to do that. I don't want you to do anything. I just want you to leave. I just want you to leave.
You're upset.
You know what? Listen, you brought my baby into the world, and I'm grateful for that. Okay, I'll always be grateful for that. But that is where it ends between us. You had no right to do what you just did.
You're upset because you responded.
No, I wasn't responding. That wasn't responding. I fell forward from exhaustion. That's what that was. And now I need to get some rest. And I need you to leave this house. I want you to go. Get out!
You know where to find me. And you will when you find me. You will.
No.